Leanne.
Hi, Steve. I'm excited about this house.
Me too.
Steve and I are headed over to our client's mid-century house today. The Collins bought it months ago. The house needs a lot of work, like $100,000 worth.
I can't wait to get my hands on this house.
I love this house. This is one of the coolest houses in this neighborhood, if not the city. This is a Don Owens house, which he worked under Frank Lloyd Wright. So they have all the design elements of what kind of was Frank Lloyd Wright's style. So there's stone, there's water features, open concept living.
It's so unique. In any room in the house, you can see into the center atrium.
I'm Leanne.
I'm glad you come up to see us.
Nice to meet you. There are going to be two showpieces for this house. One is the bridge and the entry, and the second is our custom wood cabinets in the kitchen. So we need to find really amazing wood for both these projects.
I think we're looking for some white oak.
Well,
something light.
White oak, there's someone down in the pile here.
Pretty.
I'll put them together with auto grain. No, look, it'll be one solid piece.
The Collins is going to be a really neutral home. Stone, creams, whites, marbles, and kind of these natural elements. And then the wood makes it warmer. You don't even realize it, but it does a job. Let's load these up. They're perfect. I love them.
So now that we've got the wood for the new bridge, Ed, our master carpenter, and I can tear out the old one. I can't believe how narrow it was. So it'll be new frame, sheeting, all the new boards that we got at the lumber mill, railings, and then a rope sewn through it,
yep,
which will be really cool.
Steve and I are well underway with this mid-century modern renovation, and I really wanted to see this beautiful creamy white on the panels, so I went ahead and did it without primer.
That potentially is a problem.
What's my worst case scenario for that problem?
It'll chip off where we didn't do primer. It'll be a different color.
I'll stop. You guys can take it from here.
The house feels incredible just giving it a coat of paint.
The kitchen's in, it's looking awesome. And I went and picked out the beautiful marble. It's honed and it's dreamy. We chose to do marble in the kitchen because it elevates that space and still keeps with the natural elements of the entire home. We're 6 weeks in, the fireplaces are finished and they're gorgeous. The wool wall-to-wall carpet is being installed. And we got a late request from the homeowners to add the atrium that's in the middle of the house to the renovation. So we're putting in pavers and landscaping that you can see from any room.
Hey.
You guys ready for me?
Yeah,
we're just laying it out.
The moment of truth, Ed.
Yeah, I think it's gonna look good.
We're in the south side today, so I can look at the wood that Ed and Steve are working on for Heather and Brad's cabinets, which I'm very excited about. So this is the front.
This will be the front
the
of the kitchen cabinets.
Okay.
These two are actually cut out of the same tree. So you can see once they go together and that seam goes away.
I love it. In Brad and Heather's house, they already had tons of wood on the wall with texture, so I didn't want to compete with that. So we used white oak with one cohesive grain because it's really slick and clean and it modernizes a wooden cabinet. Okay, let's talk about the finish on these.
So this is an oil base.
No, okay. Two yellow.
And this is a water base. And then this is finished with a wax.
I actually love how this looks.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like smooth is gonna feel better in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Like it's gonna feel cleaner. Gorgeous! Woo!
Greetings.
You guys really did a number on this bridge.
It's almost done. Couple more pieces. The railing is gonna be ridiculous.
I don't even need a railing. It's so roomy.
I mean, it's kind of crazy to think that they had a bridge that was half the size and no railing before.
Looks amazing. I brought over a light fixture for here to see how it looked with everything.
Oh, good.
It's gonna be globes. I want these elements of black in here, like hits of black in the whole house to ground it a little bit. We're in good shape. Bridge is almost done, the carpet's in, the atrium's done. The atrium looks beautiful. You can see it from every room in the house. The renovations are done and we used every penny of their $100,000 budget. But I think the results are really gonna blow Brad and Heather out of the water.
Hi guys.
Hi. Hello.
Are you excited to see your home?
Very excited.
Heather and Brad are here today to take a look at their house. It's reveal time. We've worked very hard on this house, total labor of love. We respect this house, we love it, and it's all beautiful and ready for you to come home. Do you wanna go in?
Yes.
Let's go.
Yes,
all right, let's go. Welcome home.
Wow.
Wow, this is amazing, Steve.
I love it.
Wow.
Because it's so kid-friendly.
I do love that.
I love it. I love, love, love it.
We went and got the wood at a lumber mill in Zelianople. We milled it all down and cut it, and we came up with this design, and I think it came out amazing.
It feels like such an epic entrance to the home. Just beautiful.
So as you see, we got the water going.
If you just listen, like, how cool is that walking in?
It's the beginning of your Zen experience here. That's for
so
sure.
So cool.
Would you like to see your living room?
Yes, I can't
After
wait.
You guys.
Okay.
Oh my.
Wow. It doesn't even look like the same place.
No.
Wow.
I love that lighting fixture. That is the coolest thing.
That is so cool.
The paint just makes it look so different.
It does.
Like, it makes it more like a home. Like, it definitely felt log cabin-like, right. You know, before and so dark.
This is a warm white. I didn't want this place to feel stark.
Ah, look outside. Wow.
Wow.
So we fixed up the atrium, which makes that entirely usable room. It actually, you know, really adds square footage to your home, it feels like. The atrium looks amazing, and the most important part is that's part of every room. So the atrium really is part of the living room, and it really is part of the kitchen. Let's go to see the kitchen.
All right.
Oh, wow.
Whoa.
Wow. I like this.
Oh, yeah, this is so cool.
That is cool.
Over here, Heather, we have your microwave.
Oh, okay.
Also, speaking of hidden, the hood is behind this. We wanted it to feel really clean and cohesive.
Oh,
so
that's
this
neat.
Is actually hood, and these are your cabinets.
Oh, wow.
That's cool.
That's the same wood as the bridge.
Oh, so you did all this too. Incredible.
We've actually put a bar over here so the kids can have breakfast in the morning.
How cool is that?
That is so cool.
So we removed the uppers right here, put some lighting, but this allows for kids, family, friends. And then we have this seating area. If you guys remember, there's dark brick wall here. And what that was doing was that was actually fighting with the stone. And we concreted this to make it more modern, make it cleaner, make it brighter, and more inviting.
Wow. It's out of this world. I'm blown away.
We have our oasis.
It is an oasis. That's a great way to describe it.
Brad had a little surprise for you.
Oh, I do have a big surprise for you.
Brad emailed me and said he had something he wanted to sneak into the house, which I love. Their first kiss was under the stained glass, and he found it later at an auction. How cute is that?
So we just had our 10-year anniversary, and I wanted to put something in the house, you know, that reminded us. anyway, so.
You made me cry.
I'm so happy that we called Leanne and Steve to come in and tackle this, to do something so amazing.
I think what you could tell is that they love this house as much as we do.
Good job.
Thanks, Steve. Good job to you.
Oh, good job to you.
No, you did
it. It's all you, Leanne. You did good.
Steve, I'd say it was 50-50 or 60-40.